Savathun's influence over the cradle grows, retake the Tree of Silver Wings.
Thank you. The Taken Queen would not have you burnt. Pledge your allegiance and be reborn.
Nokris. Oryx's foundling and exiled brother to Crota. He is now bound to Savathun as a catalyst for her interference. Silence it.
Thank you.
fail its might or be buried in the shadow of its leaves.
Nokris is an abomination. His name stricken from the world's grave. You've done well to purge his stain from this failing court.
Why would Savathun work with him?
With... Nokris is an exploited outcast, Little Light. A necromancer. Though I'm sure the Taken Queen saw value in his craft. Death rituals to buck the worm's game. I dare not wonder how she meant to wield that knowledge.
We shouldn't dwell on it, you know. He's not coming back from that.
Good riddance. Savathun's haze has diminished considerably, though not completely.
She's still out there, hiding.
Then I hope she saw what became of her brood. Hold still. I will fetch you.
Don't you see? It is as we once said. In light, there is only weakness. Only failure. Only death. But where the light takes, the dark gives. No longer will you be a pawn. No longer will you watch the lives of those you care for be lost. Remember, in darkness there is only strength, only victory, only life. Ancient power awaits you on Europa.
This transmission can be translated as contact. Not physical, more ethereal. Influential. It is conjugated here as an action with a singular subject, but innumerable objects. Guardian, what if we are not the only ones to whom the darkness speaks? This message denotes a continued, inevitable movement. Falling would be a suitable translation, though the outcome here is not necessarily negative. The die is cast. As the light from a distant star takes time to reach our eyes, an event we cannot yet perceive has already occurred. This is a biological term like camouflage, but this wording pertains to stalking predators, specifically a carnivore disguising itself to get close to its prey. The darkness could mean this as a warning, or it could simply mean to sow dissension among us. This message isn't directed at us. One translation might be petulant. The equivalent of a condescending wave of its hand or a wagged finger, like a parent rebukes a stubborn child. I think this might be meant for Savathun. This is a term for action born out of supreme conviction. Single-minded dedication, almost zealotry, driving extreme behavior. Great atrocities can be couched in valor, it suggests. Oh, wait. Not can be. Will be. Future tense. Interesting. This message translates to a state of decontamination, something like purity. Though this conjugation emphasizes loss, a purity through subtraction, willingly or otherwise. The darkness could be speaking to the taken memories of new guardians, or the boundaries we accept when we follow the light. The limitations forced upon us. In truth, it could refer to many things. This word is bound to creation, but presented here as falsehood, something like unborn. We say guardians are rebirthed by light, but I do sometimes wonder. The choice to live again was not our own. This is a linguistic oddity, a back channel, a vocal nod, a yes. The darkness implores us to continue on our current path. Apparently, it believes itself to be quite supportive. This message means contrast in the naturalistic sense, but also implies a judgment. Humanity assigns moral meaning to change, interpreting it as for better or for worse. Do we think of winter as evil because summer flowers must wither and die? We do not. And the darkness asks us why. This word denotes the moment before a change, the cusp, the brink. But it is a repetition of something that has already happened. A mistake from which no knowledge was gained. The collapse. Perhaps. Troubling. This construction is white. Not like the color, but the absence of color. An indistinct void. Overexposed sameness of a thing long dead. The white of bleached bone of the traveler.